Hey YouTube, Coppersan here. The new update changed a lot of classes. We went over it briefly in a previous video, but everyone wanted more, so today we're gonna go over all the buffs, nerfs and changes of all the warrior classes after the latest update. We're starting off with the Explorer hero class, and they received some minor changes where the action delay was reduced and the attack range of Panic was increased. The skill is a bit smoother to cast now and has more range. Shout also has had his range slightly improved, even though I wish they actually rather improved the range of Raging Blow, but we take those small improvements. The not so minor change for this class is the addition of 1 attack speed on their weapon mastery skill. This brings two-handed heroes a bit closer to one-handed heroes attack speed, but overall the difference between the two isn't that massive anyway. I usually go for two-handed sword or axe first and then switch to one-handed at later levels for the additional star force a shield can get. The Explorer Warrior and of course best class Paladin has gotten some very nice buffs as well. Their HP recovery, threaten and elemental force skills all had their action delays reduced, casting even faster now. Their 30-second iframe skill Synchro Sanctity can now be cancelled, and when you cancel the skill, some of the cooldown will be refunded. Paladin's Divine Echo range has been increased as well. This skill allows Paladins to bond with a party member, and when you then activate your attacks as a Paladin, those attacks pop out at the party member as well. Plus, you can now change which party member you want to bond to. So let's say you're bonding with an absolute noob who isn't a Paladin. Then press down and use the skill again, then press the number of party members according to the party UI, and boom, you can change with who you're bonded with. And on top of it, Pally's hands got buffed as well, and they get +1 attack speed on their weapon mastery skill. The Explorer Dark Knight has gotten a ton of buffs in a recent update. For example, their cross surge final damage increase will no longer decrease until your HP drops below 50%. Their final pack skill now is an on-off skill, so you can decide when you want to use it by simply turning it on and off again, and their Spear of Darkness now has a new function that you take 10% less damage while casting that skill, which is pretty nice because you're kinda locked in place when you use it. Their skill Radiant Evil now has a 20% ignore defense buff, and while using Calamitous Cyclone, that 5th job skill, you can now move faster, which is great because you might want to dodge when you use that skill. Actually, not really that Dark Knights dodge anything, they just face tank damage like a boss. And finally, their Darkness Aura skill has a new visual, which looks pretty cool. Finally a nice waifu for this class. Also, it has a bigger attack range and it will give more final damage. These are some pretty nice changes for this class. Adele also received some changes, but wasn't that lucky. Deemed a bit too OP by the developers, she did get a few nerfs to her survivability and defensive capabilities. Her few seconds of invincibility have been removed from her 4 job skill Eater Guard. Instead, the skill now nullifies the damage of one attack when you use it. Her Feather Float skill, the skill where she dashes backwards, has had its cost and delay increased as well. And her True Nobility skill, that was useful to help party members, now works a bit different. Adele no longer receives the damage if it would have been fatal. In accordance with these changes, two of her passive hyper skills have been modified as well. Next up is the Demon Slayer. This class has had a lot of action delays decreased, meaning that a lot of his animations play out a lot faster now. I really feel the difference when using Demon Cry, it feels so freaking smooth right now. Their 5th job skill Demon Bane can now be ended early as well, so you're no longer locked in position, and the invincibility after the skill ends lasts for 1 second longer, which is great because if you time the skill wrong and a boss hits you as soon as the attack ends, you're stuck in your place, your iframe ends, that would just spell instant death. And also after what, like 10 years, Demon Slayers finally get their own hero's will skill so they can break out of all kinds of unwanted boss effects, and of course the same goes for their blood brothers, the Demon Avenger. Demon Avengers have had their Demonic Frenzy skill adjusted to provide a bit more safety, which is kinda ironic considering they're the class with the most HP. It now doesn't bring you down anymore to 1% of your HP, but instead will drop to 30% of your max HP, which is pretty nice. And if your HP does drop below that from any attacks or whatever happens to you, your healing from your skills will no longer be reduced. The final damage increase amount has been adjusted for this skill as well and will now increase up to 35%. Their 5th job skill Revenant has had its cooldown decreased by an entire minute from 300 seconds to 240 seconds, but the duration has been reduced by 5 seconds as well. When you use this skill, your HP cannot go below 1%, but you will take all the damage that you've gotten back over time. This damage given back has been reduced as well, and those overall are some really nice changes for this class, giving them a bit more survivability, which is, again, kinda ironic. The Knight of Cygnus Warrior class, Dawn Warrior, received some very nice changes as well. Their weakness was that they always had a very small MP pool, and their attack would cost a ton of MP, but with the update, the MP cost of both their main attacks, Crescent Drive and Solar Pierce, have been reduced, and their attack range have been increased as well, so now they hit monsters even further away. I always was under the impression that these skills already had quite a big attack range, but hey, the more the merrier, I guess. The Styx Crossing Hyper skill will no longer consume MP when used, and this class has had their Rift of Damnation and Soul Eclipse 5th job skills buffed, both lasting longer now, having their uptime increased from 30 seconds to 40 seconds, and their Moon Dancer Speeding Sunset skills allows them to no longer be pushed back when those skills are used. Everything combined, this is actually quite a nice buff for this class. Like, I always thought Dumbwares were in a pretty good spot already, but I guess they're in an even better place now. Eren has received some minor changes this update. Once they hit 1000 combos, they can now activate Adrenaline Rush manually with a new skill. This gives them a bit more control over when they use that buff, and the range of their Blizzard Tempest skill has been increased as well. No big changes for Eren overall, but I think they're in a pretty okay spot already. Buff Dragon Boy Kaiser has received some nice but minor changes as well. Their Tempest Blade and Bladefall skills have had their action delays reduced by quite a bit, casting a lot faster now when you're in final form. The Grand Armor skill has been changed as well. It's now a self buff instead of a party buff that decreases the percentage HP damage taken by 12% for 15 seconds and passively reduces damage taken by 20%. Zeros have gotten some really nice buffs this update. Their final damage increased by 5% and Beta her attack speed has been increased as well. And similar to the demons, they finally have a hero's will skill now. Zeros have a chance to bind normal enemies with their critical bind skill, but this was kinda useless because why would you need to bind normal monsters all the time? So now the bind effect of the skill only works on boss monsters, but the debuff that increases critical rate and critical damage will still be applied to all monsters affected by the skill. And the legendary one sword style swordsman Hayato has received quite a few changes. Their first, second, third and fourth Sarenzan skills used to have different damage percentages on their different attacks, but this has been buffed now to always deal the highest amount of damage with every hit. This is quite a nice buff to your damage. The casting speed of their quick draw skill has been improved as well, and they can now finally double jump when the skill is active. Their Sudden Strike skill has been buffed, increasing the debuff and attack range and reducing the action delay. And their Shinsuku skill has been buffed as well, reducing the MP cost and increasing their character's movement speed compared to what it was before. Hayato's have also gotten some general buffs. Their mastery has been increased slightly, their Military Might buff has been changed from an active to a passive skill, and they've gotten a new skill called Akatsuki Trace, which looks a bit like a final attack for the Sharanzan, Rai, Blade Flash and Shinsuku skills. Also, some Hayato's appear to be bugged after yesterday's maintenance. If you cannot log into your class, make sure to send a support ticket so Nexus can fix it. I think the same goes for Jets as well. Mihil is also looking pretty good after all the recent changes. Their action delay on Royal Guard, Radiant Cross and 4-point Assault was decreased, and their self-recovery has been improved, making them heal a lot more passively. Their Sword of Light skill has had its range and damage increased by about 140% and 110% based on the stacks of Royal Guard. That's quite a bit of damage. Their 5th job skill Radiant Soul has had their cooldown increased, but now Mihil can use the skill again to activate a powerful attack. Their Light of Courage skill used to generate a Sword of Light, but that now has been moved to Radiant Soul. That's the new attack I just mentioned. The shield amount and duration of the shield that this skill Light of Courage generates has been increased slightly as well, so a bit more survivability, not that Mihil really needed that. And finally, the Night Watch Link skill has had its duration increased to 180 seconds level 2, 220 seconds level 3, which is amazing news for all classes without stance that are using that Link skill. And before we go blasting off again, let's talk about the Resistance Warrior Blaster. Blaster has also received quite a few changes. Their Rocket Rush skill has been changed quite a bit. Some part of the attack hit less damage while others hit more. Overall, the attack will now hit less monsters but does a lot more damage. Blaster also got a new skill called Magnum Cannon that looks like this. Blaster's Shotgun Punch attack has had its range increased by a massive 70%. The shockwave this attack generates has had its range increased by an additional 9%. And this is amazing because grinding with this skill was pretty tough due to how low the range was before. And Blaster's got a passive 5% increase in their critical damage and boss damage and can no longer be stunned when using their Hyper Magnum Punch skill. And there were all the changes for all the warrior classes. The thieves are up next, so stay tuned for that one. I'll try to push out a ton of videos over the next few days to go over everything quickly. And that was all for today. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Riley As, Terry Kim, Varys, Dries Sumker, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace, OTI, Saffronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Anwar NHI, Frank Bouguet, Zidir, Flidiot, Beamer WT, Knifesu, Chen125, Cloudfix, Gusus Rodriguez, Froggy11, SirTito655, Grayson Lee, Brandon Cam, Vyra, Trevor, Michael Manchaka, Raytheus, Lucky Beats, Justin Vale, Silvio Nato, Stevie Zhang, Afterlord in the Score MS, Heopan, Simak, Twozira, Joshua Alvarez, Striker Elk, NockMSS, Niu, Twidopan, Victor Sundstrom, Radicals the Alien, Stanislaus Kusuma Vegas, Ricer RU, MD Harem, Eddie Reacts to Things, Dular, Gummy Bullet, and Liran Redel. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy mapling!